The cemeteries of Britain hold many a dark secret. Over the centuries, countless victims of war, plague, great fires, all manner of the macabre, have found their eternal rest in the earthly embrace of graveyards just like this one. The very ground beneath my feet, here in this leafy suburb, contains the eternal remains of some 200,000 poor souls who passed over into the great beyond, each one with their own sadnesses, their own great sorrows, their own great loves and losses. But of all the tales that have wended their way between the monuments of this great stone garden of death, it is doubtful that there could be any more beguiling, more eerie and unsettling than that of the Highgate vampire.
And as the summer dies, the shadows start to move. See them dancing spring among the ivy trees. And now the boughs turn verdant green to gold. Wild flowers fade, this year is growing old. October day, when you first walked to walk my open grave, awesome girl lay down beneath the tree. Auburn hair, the color of the leaves, a little death never hurt anyone. So was the hour of dust in the season of mists on your pale neck, your fate sealed with a kiss, call rims round your eyes like cinerary ash. In my cold embrace, you fell into a trance. Egyptian Avenue, through Iron Gates, into the catacombs, autumn girl lay down beneath the trees, auburn hair, the color of the leaves, a little death never hurt anyone, so won't you have passed, the colors never fade, and so we're lost in time. Our dawn will